Hey guys, it's Broken Repairs, and welcome back to my FIFA has sent Liverpool Grandma where last time I left off. I picked up my first win in my first game in the FA Cup for Season 2, and I also picked up a win in the first leg of my Capital One Cup semi-final game against Manchester City. And in this episode, I have games against Spurs and Crystal Palace. The second leg against Manchester City is in between the games, but it will be simmed. I did decide I am going to sim it. Hopefully, I won't regret that decision. We will see.
First touch, and the ball is in play, off we go. This is today's Tottenham Hotspur team. Michel Vaughan.
First things first, I have to beat Spurs, who may have done a huge favor to the whole league in real life when they recently ended Chelsea's seemingly unstoppable rampage of victories. He's at 13. So they didn't get the 14th win.
Attackers to feed on from the goalkeeper that time.
The opportunity is there for other teams to contribute to a title race.
No difficulty at all for Vorming goal.
He's be at Liverpool, Arsenal, Manchester City, Manchester United, or even Spurs themselves.
Such an open, expansive game, it does leave them vulnerable at
times. Spurs' win did take them up into third, so they have to be.
There's some potential in this move.
Considered among the contenders. A lot of people, when they were predicting their league tables, left Spurs out of the top four, and I was like, what are they doing? Spurs have not sold anyone. If they had sold a Harry Kane or Son or someone like that, someone key to their team, if one of those had left, I would be like, yeah, they're going to struggle. But I was like, scratching my head, trying to figure out what was the reasoning behind leaving Spurs out of the top four. And there, I think, especially with that win over Chelsea, they are showing that they are definitely going to make a big impact in the race for top four. Even in the race for the title. So, don't worry, Spurs fans. He don't disvalue you. Even if some other people are counting you out before the season frickin' began.
Sturridge, great stop.
So the big question is, who can take advantage of this? I don't know. It probably won't be Liverpool because of our. Because we're playing a dud, because we know for a fact we're playing a dud. You know why we're playing our dud? Our next Premier League game is Worcester United. Yep, Jose Mourinho, and they're parking the bus. Because I would recommend that we.
Visiting team today because the home side.
He blocked the entrance so they can't get the bus in, but I don't think that we're that foreseeing. So, yeah, that's gonna be an annoying little fucking shit thing. So, probably won't be Liverpool taking advantage. So, Good luck, Spurs Arsenal. Boy. Well, probably because you have the best chances. It's Man United and Man City can go for it.
Transition happened quickly.
And that goalkeeper can just saunter out and pick that up. And he could get away here. Here's the shot. Over the top.
Sturridge. What was that? Whoa, that first half went by quick. Jesus Christ. I can't even fucking miss it. It went really quick. Did they have any added time or anything? Senior.
They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position.
Oh! Ah! Dumb whore. Oh yeah, if you didn't see my last video of this crime, what's the new thing in football is referees aren't wankers, they're whores. You know why? Because they're paid up off, they pay that money and then they fuck you.
Ericsson.
Who?
Challenge.
It's exactly like a whore, except someone else is paying for you getting fucked.
Sadio Mane almost stealthily into scoring position here. Not picked up.
Whether it be real life or in game, when you get fucked, it's not as pleasurable as it would be to really fuck up more.
But in terms of form, you'd have called it even, wouldn't you? Well, you would. And I'd like to see the stats at the
fucking
end.
Fucking whore with fucking HIV. I
think it was a game that deserved a goal. Now we've got it. Eric Lamella. David Alaba. Into the attacking third. And they're keeping the ball now. Opportunity now. He's kept it out.
Anyway, Sadio Mane has broken the deadlock. And Daniel Sturridge almost instantly piled some misery onto Spurs. But Warren was equal to the shot. The hood.
Sturridge. Stopped him.
Ah! A pass intended for Firmino. I thought for a second it was going to come to Mane.
Sports, don't forget
the final point.
The coverage of the Premier League fixture.
So for a goal kick, apparently. Just one that went out for a corner, but hey. Ow! Help! No. My knuckles started hurting for no reason.
Chance for his second goal of the match. The goalkeeper determined not to be here.
I think he was disappointed how he got beaten the first, so made amends there.
The shot's on.
Mane! What a save by Vaughan.
The corner. Matip! Super stop by the goalkeeper. He's hung on to the ball as well. Stopping the pass getting through with a good piece of anticipation.
So we'll clear that easily enough. Chan. Go on, a nice easy ball to Firmino. Clean through. Roberto Firmino! Are you kidding me? Or another unbelievable save. Of course.
And the cross is
put that back in, Evan. Vertonghen clears, you stupid Belgian prick.
Coutinho. And it'll go.
Coutinho. To his Brazilian brother from another mother. That went out of Davis, that's a throw on me. Thank you. Sturridge. The hood! Oh, beautiful! Oh, what a goal that was. The dude, were, I think only like his second goal of the season, might be a third, but it is a fantastic goal, and it comes at just the right time, because it puts Spurs right there, in favorable position, and it's so we won't find out how many goals the dude has, but he doesn't have that many, so
a substitute is going to come off.
4 or 5 at the most would be my guess.
Well, I think
Oh, with that acrobatic clearance.
Might not be pretty.
Tongan. Oh, absolutely fuck off, you dumb Belgian piece of shit. Yes. Oh, come. Vertonghen again, and fucking
well, you run the risk.
Impatience and anger, I took a chunk out of freaking out. I think it was Trippier I ended up challenging. He initially did give away the free kick. Because it was Vertonghen I won the ball off initially. Fairly. Mane! Oh, for God's sake. I mean, the 3 points are wrapped up, but I'd still like more goals. But form has just been on point most game. Like,
and that's a win confirmed for Liverpool.
Really, nothing he could more he could do apart from like.
Very professional.
As long as they can keep things together in this.
The goals were like out of his control. Well, he did his job to the best of his abilities. He saved a shit ton in that match.
Bournemouth.
So
Norwich City 1.
I wouldn't be surprised if Bournemouth had gotten got freaking match there. Oh yeah, I don't know if you guys saw. No wait, I did. I did include that, didn't I?
Nil.
Crystal Palace lost again, because of course they did. Chelsea won though, but so it looks like Chelsea, I guess this is Chelsea now going to pull away from Palace and
West Bromwich Albion 2.
Make it into a two-horse race. I mean, that's what probably you'd expect to happen. No guarantee that's going to happen. Because
in second,
if there's anything guaranteed in this game, is that there's nothing guaranteed in this game.
In fourth, Arsenal with 38.
I want to make sure I have the best team available for the match. Let's see. Diwara.
Play
him on the bench. Jojo, he can be on the bench.
And then reading up the table, second bottom, Norwich City with 14
Reading
points.
And,
third bottom, Middlesbrough
Moore
with 16
start.
Points.
Fourth Lojo
bottom, Swansea City with 20 points.
Lory.
Fifth bottom, moving down, are West Ham United with 23 points.
Yeah, I think I'm happy with that. I think that's what I'm going to go with. I have confidence that team should be able to avoid being defeated by Manchester City by more than 3 goals. Because if it's more than 3 goals, I'm fucked. Because if it goes to extra time, I can't help. Them. If it goes to penalties, I can't help them. I just hope that if the game is going to penalties, that the computer has the wherewithal to bring on David Alaba. Will it have that foresight? Hopefully that won't be necessary. Oh wait, what? Oh, the pass game is next. Yes, it got rescheduled. The Manchester City game got rescheduled. So I don't have to worry about it yet. I can not even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. Thank you, Grimsby, for taking my dude there on loan. Well, Chelsea are definitely going to get away from Crystal Palace if their next game is me. Okay, I'm not interested in entertaining any more offers for Di Macarini, especially because I'm not. That was weird. I just got more prize money from the FA Cup. Wow. That's a big draw. Look who it is. It's Arsenal. So that'll be the first game of the next episode. Wow. Really? An Arsenal double bill. Talk about how unlikely is that? Chelsea lost. They're still on 43 points. So. Does anyone want to provide a semi-decent challenge to me for the title? Anyone? Anyone at all? Arsenal have gone above Crystal Palace. Palace are now down to 4th, 1 point above Manchester United. Unfortunately for them, if the worst possible game in next on their schedule. Because the champs are in town. Yes, I know it's Di Macarini asked me to play, but I can just bring him on in like the second half.
Hi there, everybody. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith, and our match today comes from the Premier League.
Oh crap!
Manchester City.
I forgot to. Make my substitutions in the game against Spurs. Game went by so quickly. Yeah, I completely forgot to do it again. And that's not the first time it's happened. They're not going to get that 50%, are they?
Steve Mandanda starts in goal. Oh, he's through.
Mane! Oh, what a start. What a start. 5 minutes and Sadio Mane is already making it 1-0. Oh.
Speed, control as well at that pace. It takes a bit of doing, but they got it absolutely right.
Well, they enjoyed that. And
he gave Mandanda the eyes. And then coolly placed it in the bottom corner. Taking his tally to 30 for the second season running. Yo, Mane is easily going to surpass what he scored last season, which was like 36 or something like that.
Being G'd up by their manager, not to take this one lightly, but it was a pretty comfortable win. They had the superiority on their own ground, but, you know, football is strange.
Oh, for me, I'll avoid the challenge, Mane! Second time asking Delaney. I don't know how much he knew about it, but he got in the way. And denied Mane goal number 31. at the expense of a corner.
Goes for goal with the header.
Which Mané decides he's going to header it instead of letting it fall to his feet, which is what I thought he was going to do when they pressed circle. Should have anticipated that he would header it. Alaba! Oh, Mandanda, what a good save. That shot was... It looked like it was destined for the back of the net, but Mandanda had different ideas. Mané! Oh, the bar. It didn't take any deflections or anything like that, so it's a goal kick. Daniel Sturridge! Oh! Done! And has to clear it quickly. Arnautovic didn't go out of play there, really. Interesting.
So, run of victories. A massive run of victories that they want to extend to the... Benteke! Good work by the...
Benteke with the most terrible shot I've ever seen. Mané. Oh! Going past Crystal Palace players like they're not even there, and then the simplest finish again. It makes Mandanda look so stupid.
Well, he's doubled up here with his...
The pace of Mané is almost overpowered, man. Slots it home. Cool as you like. I mean, changing him to a striker was the best decision I have ever made in FIFA. I'm not even going to bullshit you. Because if he was a right mid, he would be lost. He wouldn't be scoring this amount of goals. I have no idea where my goals would have come from last season if Mané wasn't around. Like, I always... from the minute... I got this game, I knew I was going to play here two up front with Origi and Mané. And then I saw Mané was put down in the game as a freaking right mid. I was like, why is he a right mid? He's a striker. Not even a central forward, he was a right mid. And I'm like, I don't care, you can have him down as that he can play right mid. But don't make him a right mid. Make him a center forward or a striker. It's bullshit, man. It is absolutely 100% bullshit.
The referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle. Patience is the name of the game at the moment. And now the shot!
My only wish is that I could do the same thing in Ultimate Team. Because he would make a fantastic addition striker to the team.
And here's the shot. The keeper might be needed again. He didn't hang on to the ball. Cleared his lines.
To any team, he would be an amazing striker. And yet, all you can do is make him a right wing or a right forward. Anyway.
No, you didn't. I mean, he's a cool head and he's one that he never likes to smash the ball.
Enough about EA's blunders. There's Daniel Sturridge. Would like to interrupt because he scored the third goal of the game. I like it showing Alan Parshu because he's not there anymore. It's Sam Allardyce now.
Here's Pizarro.
Poor Alan is out of a fucking job. He got replaced by the scummiest bastard in English football. Well, one of the scummiest bastards in English football. Well, there's a lot of people who can easily earn the title of scummiest person in English football. Well, ahead of Sam Allardyce. I mean, there's Joey Barton, Raheem Sterling, who is 100% the scummiest person, not just in English football, but in the history of the game, in the history of man.
You don't often get a first half as one-sided as this one. They've been very good, the team that are leading, of course. On to the attack now. And here's the cross. The break is definitely on. And shoots! Oh, great work by the keeper.
Really? Hey, Emery Chan makes it 4-0. Oh, beautiful. 50 minutes in. 100% I'm going to be beating Crystal Palace. And extending my lead at the top of the table. Oh, to 23 points.
Looking for more at 4-0.
It's just getting ridiculous, man. It's just getting ridiculous.
Could have stopped it, the referee. Crystal Palace allowed to play on because of the advantage rule. It's looking good, this move.
This is game 22, so there are 16 games remaining.
Well, he's taken a touch there of the defender. It will be a corner.
After this one,
second leg EFL Cup fixture, Liverpool, they'll be facing. He's got his shot off now. Good piece of tackling there. It's Mane.
Sturridge. Coutinho gets away from a pass player, and oh, and then they got enough on it to make sure it wasn't 5-0. As the ball is going out, I'm gonna make my changes. Bring on Divock Origi, bring on Feor, and Moya. I'm gonna bring Moya on instead of Philippe because he can. He can take a rest. He's done his part. Without a doubt. Unlucky, Nicholas.
Attacking now. Giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing. A real chance here.
Dude! Oh, I thought there was another goal in it. Maybe there is. Moya! Yes, there is.
A matter of minutes. I'm not sure he's touched the ball before.
Unbelievable.
Oh. Important moment. Maybe the most important moment in the match. They shouldn't be
caught. Divo, could you not have worn black gloves? You look really weird with red gloves on with the black jersey. It looks like his hands are bleeding or something.
If you're losing count, it's 5-0. Delaney. Liverpool for so long.
He walked the red-handed it's striker. Or some shit like that.
Looking good now.
It's looking very good indeed. They have played some really confident stuff. Everybody seems certain of their jobs. They've settled into a shape. Who knows? Could be glory at the end of this.
Beautiful ball over. Her Feor. Whips it in. Moya! Too high.
Shots on.
Ring. Yeah, kind of humped it over the fucking bar. Or sorry, lumped it, not humped it. That's a completely different action.
Neither side able to dwell on the ball for very long here. Marco Arnautovic. Intercepted well. Here's a chance. This could be it.
Well, yeah. It's going to fall to Origi. It's 6-0. With his red gloves on. I mean, I wouldn't mind the red gloves as much as if they were, you know, Liverpool branded, but they're just plain red gloves. The fuck, Origi?
As the game is restarted, we've got 10 minutes left on the clock. Benteke. 6-0. That might well be the final score. There's not much time left. So this is going to have a devastating effect on the next game, isn't it?
Well, Liverpool go up against Manchester City. And they've done pretty well out here. They'll be pleased if they win it.
Nathaniel Clyne. Emre Can.
Can. Mane. Where? Origi. Penalty!
Oh, can you believe it? It is a
penalty. I don't know how to pronounce this dude's name. Whoever he is, he's in the book, and he's an idiot. Davalala is perfect from penalties, but we have a player who's... No. Who's weighing on a hat-trick? Come on. Oh! He missed the penalty, but he scored the rebound. And Mane gets his hat-trick. Heck. I've missed my first penalty of the season. But it wasn't Dava Alaba, so he's still perfect on them. That was Mane's first penalty for Liverpool, I think.
Really, one team in it.
I think it is. Yeah, Alaba's been taking my penalties since season one. I didn't get that many in season.
Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. The crosses need to be better. Well, I thought so.
No, Milner was taking them in season one. It was only in.
Good pass.
At the end of the season, I realized how good Alaba was at them.
And they've got a corner. Matip! That's great hands from the goalkeeper to make that kind of save. And that's a win.
A brilliant win.
Well, this is.
And the players are running on the pitch.
Call it in the way that they were so ruthless with the
opposition. Did anyone else see that? My subs, like, freaking. Bolted onto the pitch like this is the title secure. I mean, I know we're decimating the table with an alarming rate for everyone below us, but we haven't won the title yet. I don't think we've secured top four. No, I mean, Man United, who are in fifth.
A couple of changes to Crystal
Palace. If they're only 1 point behind Palace. This, and we're all, and Palace are on 40 points. This puts us 26 ahead of them. As I said, that was only game number 22, so there's still 16 games after this, so. No. We're still a ways off even securing the,
Two, Tottenham Hotspur.
Okay. The title, that's an interesting little news article. Apparently Everton signed Daley Blind. Why? Talk about the talk about a bad sign. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. Until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day. Peace.
Bottom of the table, Brighton and Hove Albion with 6 points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Norwich City with 14 points.